strain.
Today we are going to discuss what is pelvic strain and how it is done. Okay. Pelvic assessment means internal examination of the pelvis from obstetric point of view, whether there is adequate space for the fetal head to come out from the brim, latest pelvic admission, least pelvic admission, and outlet. So, assess broadly, we assess the pelvis in four planes. They are imaginary planes: plane of greatest pelvic admission, plane of inlay, plane of greatest pelvic admission, plane of least pelvic admission. So, how do I assess the pelvis? When I assess the plane of inlay, I assess with my fingers. Okay? There are five steps. Those five steps only you should remember one after the other. You work up those five sentences so in the examination there is no problem to remember it. Okay? So, how do you write down your findings? I write down. Sacral promontory is not reached. Second sentence. Sacrum is well broad. Then I go laterally. These are the sacrosacral notches. I reach in two fingers on either side. Then I turn my finger this way. Ischia spine is not prominent. Means they are okay. There is adequate space here. Then subpubic angle is wide. And PDA, transfer lamina prominent, is over. So in short, we have to remember only five sentences to when we are communicating on the pelvic assessment. In the examination, just remember five sentences. First sentence is sacral promontory not reached, sacrum is well formed, sacrosacral notches between two fingers, ischial spine is not prominent, subpubic angle wide, and PDO is 4 knuckles. This is how we assess the PDO. These are the five sentences. This is how you interpret the pelvic assessment findings. When I was assessing the outlet, that time we have discussed that I should comment about the sacral promontory. When sacral promontory is not reached, means inlet is adequate. Okay? When I come down at the level of the latest pelvic admission, if the sacrum is well formed, means there is adequate space for the fetal head to come out. Then I come down at the least pelvic admission. If these spines, these are the ischial spines, these are the ischial fibrosities, these are the iliac spines, these are the iliac spines, these are the ischial spines, or the ischial bone, and these are the ischial fibrosities, they are big here. So these are the ischial spines. Okay? So at the level of least pelvic dimension, it should be 10 cm. This distance should be 10 cm. So if they are not prominent, means it is adequate. If they are prominent, means if they are the distance, interspinal distance is less than 10 cm, means there is pelvic contraction at the midplane. Outlet contraction, how do you assess? The PDO is 4 knuckles, subpubic angle is wide. In the examination, if they ask you the question, which type of pelvis there is inlet, midplane, and outlet contraction? Android type of pelvis, there is panelic of pelvis, means the inlet is triangular, midplane is contracted, outlet is also contracted. So, it is panelic type of pelvis. With the male type of pelvis, where occipital posterior position is common. The flat pelvis, there is inlet contraction, means this distance is less, like grand mal tibia, or generally contracted pelvis. All planes are less. In generally contracted pelvis, what will be my finding? Sacral promontory reached with ease or difficulty, that can be the command. Sacrum is flat. Sacrosacral notches not admitting two fingers. Ischial spines are prominent, subpubic angle is narrow, and PDO is 3 knuckles. So this will be the finding in the short, delicate pelvis or generally contracted pelvis. What will be your finding in flat pelvis? Flat pelvis, this distance is less, rest is okay. Means what? The eyes comment, my comment will be, sacral promontory is reached, sacrum is flat, of course, will be there because there is compression of the pelvis this way. And the ischial spines may not be prominent. PDO is 4 knuckles like this, and subpubic angle is wide and 2 fingers. So this is how the final in the flat pelvis random prepare. So now you can comment about what is pelvic assessment. The questions asked are, what is pelvic assessment? How do you interpret your findings? At what level the contraction is in android pelvis and at what level the contraction is in flat pelvis. What are the effect of this pelvis in labor? Means what is the risk in flat pelvis? Structural uterus, tarsus lag, abnormal presentation. What is the risk in android pelvis? When the fissure spines are prominent and tibia is also contracted, there is a chance of deep transverse arrest. And occipital posterior hip position is there in cases of android pelvis or mid-pain and outer pelvis.